Coach Lofton, thanks so much for joining us. Appreciate your time. You're 2-0 to start the season, and you've gotten both wins in very close ball games, and I think that has to please you and your coaching staff, the way that your team has played good close games and come out with winners each time.
Well, no question about it. You want to win every chance you can, and we've been fortunate. You know, it's not easy to come from behind, but, you know, the way the college game is today, Reed, the games can change, and when you get some momentum like we were fortunate to do in both of those games, they can change, and fortunately for us, they did change and turn out to be victories.
Well, talk about the importance of playing tough exhibition games, because your exhibition schedule was very difficult.
Well, I don't think there's any question, and, you know, there are several reasons that we play the games. The competition level is good. The players enjoy playing against, you know, two of the exhibitions were against Division I competition, and then financially it's good for our basketball program to play those games. But the players enjoy it, and that's one of the big things. It doesn't count against your record. And so fortunately we're located where we are that we can get some of those games, and hopefully we'll continue to get some of those games in the future. But I do think it helps you. You know, there's not a lot of pressure in those games in terms of winning and losing, but you every game you want to win, and certainly we go into those games trying to win, and we have won a few of those. You know, we did play William Carey, and we made it an exhibition game, and that's due to you're only allowed 26 games during the regular season, and we ended up with 27, so we had to count one game against somebody as an exhibition, and since it was early in the year, we just decided to count the William Carey game. Now that we've won it, we might want to change and count something else, but you can't do that. And fortunately, I think the three exhibition games helped prepare us. We're still a work in progress. You know, as you said, we're 2-0, and we got Delta State coming Thursday night, and certainly that's going to be a challenge. But, you know, I like our basketball team. We've got a good group of high-quality character kids. We don't always play the best basketball at times, and we've kind of been inconsistent from an offensive standpoint, where we've gone through periods where we didn't score the basketball like we're going to need to beat the better teams in our conference. But I think that will come over time, and, you know, we are doing some good things. Just having some of those inconsistent moments, and we got to get those corrected.
Stacy Mack, a returning player for this team, he's averaging 14 and 12 over the first two ball games, and it really does look like he's beefed up a little bit, ready for the physical nature of a conference schedule.
Well, he's gotten himself in better condition. I think he's lost about 15 to 20 pounds, which that was at my request. Stay away from those buffets and don't be a buffet buster, as the coach is. But we got to get him the ball more. You know, he's got a lot of, he's improved his free throw shooting, and he's improved finishing around the basket. And that's something that he hadn't done prior to this year. And so we've got to find a way to get that ball inside to him and let him go to work. And, you know, we tell our guys there's two things that can happen when the ball gets inside, and both of them are bad. And for us, they'll be good. And, you know, usually your opponent will either score it or get fouled. And that's where most of the fouls are called. And so, you know, that's where we lead the conference in free throw shooting, which is something that we hadn't done around here in a while. We're shooting over 80% from the free throw line. And so we want to get there. And one of the best ways to get there is to feed that ball into the post to not just Stacy, but all our post players.
Brandon Boston's a newcomer, is a freshman on this team, and just in seeing him play, it really does look like he has a great deal of poise on the court, doesn't get ruffled a whole lot. That probably will change at some point this season, but so far, he's displayed some real maturity as a freshman.
He's a mature 18-year-old. He's got a lot of offensive skills. We knew that coming out of Pearl High School. He's not where we want him to be in terms of defensively, and he's got to improve there, and I'm sure he will. And he's got to get tougher, as does our entire basketball team. You know, we haven't rebounded the ball well, and we've got to get that fixed before Thursday night with Delta State if we're going to be successful. But we're really proud of the four freshmen we got, and certainly Brandon has played well and is in the rotation and will continue to be in the rotation. You know, there's no substitute, Reed, for scoring the basketball, and he can shoot. So you know, just really excited about him. He's a really good student, great family, and certainly represents what Mississippi College is all about.
Well, Delta State here in the first ball game of the conference schedule, and they still have Devin Schmidt. He's still pouring it in. So if you're going to have a game plan to beat Delta State, you got to at least address what he brings to the court.
There's no question. I think they were 23rd in the country prior to their loss Sunday at Arkansas-Monticello. Unfortunately for the Choctaws, Devin had a bad game and went 4-for-20. And so he doesn't he has a bad one every three or four, but he usually comes back with vengeance. And so, you know, hopefully the Golden Dome will get him. You know, he played fairly well here last year in our victory over Delta. But, you know, he's going to get his. He's the preseason conference player of the year in the league. And he takes enough shots that he's going to end up with quite a few points. You got to just hope he doesn't do something crazy and get, you know, 30 or 40 on you. And if he gets his average 25, well, then, you know, if you do a good job on their other players, and I think that's the key to having success against Delta State, you know he's going to do his thing. He does it every night. It's those other guys that you got to keep in check, and hopefully we'll be able to do that.
Coach, we're looking forward to this season. Thanks so much for your time. Good luck.
Thank you. Appreciate you, and appreciate you having me.